80-year-old child presented to emergency department with a 2-day history of neck pain, which began 24 hours after an adenotonsillectomy surgery and progressed to painful neck stiffness and limited movement, but physical examination was unremarkable. Remember, this can be a very rare cervical spine condition, which was reported in 1930 by Pierre A. Grisel, a French physician, so named after him as Grisel syndrome, which is a rare cervical spine condition characterized by non-traumatic rotary subluxation of the atlantoaxial joint, seen commonly in children and young adults. The causes can be infection, both cervical and tonsillar abscess, and also as a complication of adenoid or adenotonsillectomy surgery. The increased laxity of the joint ligament because of the inflammation will lead to atlantoaxial instability. The clinical features is a painful torticollis, neck stiffness, pain and high-grade fever, and also non-specific signs of infection. The painful torticollis is the most characteristic symptom of this condition. We can differentiate this from muscular torticollis by the three clinical signs. One is the spinous process of the axis vertebra is palpably deviated to the direction of head rotation. Second, sternocleidomastoid muscle on the side of the direction of head rotation may exhibit spasm. And third is inability to rotate the head past the middle in the opposite direction of that of injury. The diagnosis is mainly by clinical assessment and also by imaging. Contrast enhanced CT scan with 3D reconstruction, that is three-dimensional reconstruction, is the investigation of choice. Normally, the distance between the dense axis and the posterior aspect of the anterior arch of atlas is normally it is 2 to 3 millimeters. While in children, this distance can be up to a maximum of 5 millimeters. If this distance, that is the distance between the dense axis and the posterior aspect of the anterior arch of atlas, if it is exceeding 5 millimeter, you should suspect atlantoaxial subluxation. Rotary atlantoaxial subluxation with anterior displacement of the atlas relative to axis. You can see that. And second figure is the three-dimensional reconstruction of the first image. And the third figure is showing a 3D reconstruction of the axial CT scan showing anterior displacement of the atlas relative to axis. And here also, this is a contrast enhanced CT scan on bone windows with axial and reformated oblique images. And you can see the atlantoaxial subluxation of C1 on C2, which is more apparent on the left side. The distance between the axis and the posterior aspect of the anterior arch of atlas, shown here is a red line. You can see the lengthening, that is, it exceeds 5 millimeter. Here it is almost 6.5 millimeters. Here also you can see the subluxation very well, especially in that 3D reconstructed image. And this also a 3D surface rendered image, beautifully illustrating torticollis and subluxation. There are four types of atlantoaxial subluxation according to Fielding. So in Fielding classification, the risk of developing a spinal cord compression increases from type 1 to type 4. This is applicable in case of Grisel syndrome also. Primary treatment of early detected Grisel syndrome is conservative. We can use external support such as a Philadelphia cervical collar, a Minerva braces or a sterno-occipitomandibular immobilizer, along with the muscle relaxants, and if primary infection is there, treat it with antibiotics or anti-inflammatory. So the primary modality of treatment is conservative. You should know the different types of external supports. So one is Philadelphia collar. Philadelphia cervical collar is used mainly in patients with tracheostomy, and this gives a very good support of the chin area also. This is Minerva braces. You should identify this type of external supports. That's why I am giving the illustrations. Sternooccipitomandibular immobilizer or SOM immobilizer. Grisel syndrome need an early detection and early treatment. Patients with an unreduced atlantoaxial subluxation for greater than 3 weeks are at an increased risk for recurrence and also permanent deformity due to chronic changes in the transverse and alar ligament. So if conservative treatment fails to achieve a stable reduction, or if it is followed by neurological symptom, arthrodesis of the first and second cervical vertebra is indicated. Arthrodesis of the first and second cervical vertebra. So if primary conservative treatment is failing, you have to go for an arthrodesis of C1, C2, because there can be chances of permanent deformity. So to summarize, Grisel syndrome is a rare but dangerous complication that can go unnoticed in an early phase, and this can be a major cause of morbidity and mortality following infection or head and neck procedures or interventions. So early recognition and treatment is mandatory to prevent devastating consequences.